Hello, my name is Anne Currie, and I am a veteran software engineer. I've been in the tech industry for nearly 30 years now, working on a variety of different things from really hard, hardcore C server stuff in the 90s through to modern operation stuff now. And I'm also one of the part of the leadership team of the Green Software Foundation, which is a new Linux foundation devoted to how we can make the tech industry, how we can basically manage the energy transition from our side, from the tech side, how we can contribute, how we can work in that new environment. But today I'm here to talk to you because I am one of the co-authors of the new O'Reilly book, Building Green Software. And there are three of us, all of whom are key folk in the Green Software Foundation, who are working on that book. And hopefully it will be a kind of a nice, easy to read introduction to code efficiency, operational efficiency, carbon awareness, time shifting, how FinOps, how everything fits together to get with the green software transition, the transition from fossil fueled energy, which is massively on demand, you can get it whenever you want, to renewable energy, which is not so readily available. So the book is a very broad introduction. It won't be going deep. It won't be deep diving on any. Well, it won't be deep diving in. If you want a whole book on a particular subject, I'm sure O'Reilly will start to produce those. But because given that we're already getting a lot of positive feedback on the book we've done, so the book officially comes out in first quarter next year. Early next year, but what is actually happening? And this is the O'Reilly way of doing things now, which I appreciate. That as we write each chapter with a bit of they do a bit of minimal editing, and then it goes straight up on the O'Reilly Safari site. So if you have an O'Reilly Safari subscription, you can start reading the chapters, and there's one coming every month. And the one that is available already is the introduction. And the reason, and there was quite a lot of method to our deciding we were going to go live with the introduction first, because the introduction is basically a summary of everything we're going to say. It's kind of a nice introduction to what are all the key concepts, what do you need to do, what do you need to be thinking about. And it should be, hopefully, it should be a nice, easy read. We're already getting quite a lot of reads on it, so that's good. It's looking like a lot of people want to know how we need to be accommodating this new world of power is not necessarily going to be available. Well, power will not be available instantly everywhere. Now, eventually it will. The whole point of an energy transition is eventually you have transitioned. At some point, we are back in the state where we are now, where power is very readily available. It's free. You just don't need to think about it. But maybe for the next couple of decades, that's not going to be the case, because thing is about a gas-fired power station or even a coal-fired power station is they're quite reliable. They provide great baseline power. You just turn them on and you've got, literally at the flick of a switch, you have energy available to you. But renewables are not like that. And we've got several problems with the way the renewables work. I mean, obviously, they're extremely cheap when they are running. So when the sunshine, the wind's blowing, there's tons of power. We have everything we might possibly want and need to use. But when the wind isn't blowing or the sun isn't shining, or it's night, for example, then things get a little bit more hairy. And for the next few years, we are going to have to cope with all that kind of stuff. And then we've got a couple of tools in our toolbox, which is what we talk about in the introduction. We've got being more efficient with power and being more aware. So being aware of what the carbon intensity of the grid is at any moment and shifting what you're doing so that you run more when the sun is shining, whatever, and you run less when it isn't. Because in the long run, we will have solutions. We will have batteries and we will have great grids that can transfer power from the other side of the world where the sun is shining. But we're quite a long way off that. That's going to take quite some time. So we need to be thinking about how things work in the meantime. And at the moment, we're not necessarily paying much more for power that's dirty versus power that's clean. But I think we all know that that situation isn't going to continue forever. So there's a kind of FinOps element to this as well, that it will cost, a punishing amount if you have an all on-demand, always-on application that's very energy heavy and is running when the only thing to, available to power it is a coal-fired power station. So we have an enormous amount of ability to shift things around in the tech industry, and we're very clever. So we really do need to be leading the field on this. So this book is all about all of these different concepts that all the different ways, all the different ideas, all the different things that folk are coming up with. We're my co-authors. We've got three of us. There's me. There's Sara Bergman, who's based in Norway, Swedish, based in Norway, works for Microsoft. And we've got Sarah Sue, who is Taiwanese, lives in London, works as an SRE for Goldman Sachs. So we're trying to approach this from all different angles, make sure we've got lots of different perspectives in this. We're going out, we're talking to people all over the place. Our foreword will be written by Adrian Cockcroft, lately of AWS Sustainability. So we're trying to make sure that we get a lot of points of view. And O'Reilly have come up with this clever scheme, which apparently they do all the time, but I hadn't really heard about it before, where you release chapters as you go. And we're using that to try and get people to give us feedback on what they want to see and what isn't in the book at the moment. So we're very keen to get folks to read those chapters. So introduction with the first chapter. The second chapter will be measurement, which was written. Well, the lead on that chapter is Sara Bergman. So I think next time we'll probably have her coming in to talk about that. We're under some time pressure with Sara because she's heavily pregnant and is due to have a baby in 6 weeks' time. So we have to push her stuff out, get her stuff out and get her talking about it before she has to go home, potentially. And then after that, we'll get Sarah Sue in to talk about her chapter. She's going to own the carbon efficiency chapter. So I hope that gives you some kind of an idea about what's coming in the book and what we want from you, which is feedback. We want ideas. We want you to ask all the questions that you want answered so we can make sure we do answer them, because we've got the time. We can incorporate what you say as we go along. So it's a community. It's a community project. We need your feedback. We need your questions. And hopefully we'll get them.
Subscribe to the GOTO YouTube channel now and join the experts in person or online at any upcoming GOTO conference using the promo code BOOKCLUB. Visit gotopia.tech to learn more.